Hey guys, I'm Alexi from Boostpower Marine, and I got a couple tech questions written in here to alexi@boostpower.com. It says here, please explain the proper way to plumb an oil filter before or after the oil cooler. Your help would be appreciated. It says John from Texas here. All right. Well, here's a typical billet oil slash fuel filter head. You can use it any which way. It just depends on the threads and what filter you want to put on it. My personal opinion is I like to filter everything right before it goes into the motor. So there's no chance an oil cooler tube or a piece of solder from inside the tube or anything can get in this engine. They're just too expensive to not protect at the engine, where if you have a failure, I'd rather buy an oil cooler to not clean, you know? So, but anyway, some people do it the other way around. They filter, then cool the oil, then go into the motor, which is, it's probably okay because you're protecting the oil cooler as well. But I don't trust oil coolers, so we've seen enough of them come apart, so I'm not having it. I'd rather trap the water and any debris or whatever could be caught in there in the manufacturing process that you can't flush through. It's amazing when you can't flush through an oil cooler. So, and in our rule here at Boost Power is we don't clean them. We just replace them, because if you try to clean them, you think they're clean, they're not, including the lines. I mean, you clean a line and there's debris in there stuck in between the barrel of the fitting or something you can't see, and then it causes a catastrophe later. So our rule in house is replace the hoses, replace the oil cooler itself, and never worry about it. It's a $400 to $500 expense that'll save a $50,000+ motor, or even your $5,000 motor. So here's the filter head, as you can see here. This is the inlet to the engine. A lot of people get this
so
backwards.
On your engine, you're gonna have an oil filter that screws on to the block itself.
The oil comes in to the outside of the filter and exits the middle clean into the engine. So when you plumb it, when it's remote located, you want to make sure that the oil is exiting out of the engine on the outside and entering the engine through the middle. But a lot of people get this backwards. You got to make sure you're coming out of the engine into the outside of the filter, wherever it's located, flowing through the filter and back to the center of the adapter, and then make sure it gets to the center port on the engine. So it's clean oil filtered proper direction back to the engine. Now some of these oil filters have a bypass in them. So if they see a differential of 20 pounds or 15 pounds, depending on the brand, it will actually bypass the oil filter. A lot of these things, when you start them up, they're not even
so
filtered.
If you use a non-bypass filter, such as the Morosos or a couple of the Wix part numbers,
just beware that as the filter decays, your oil pressure will also start decaying, because it will not be able to flow through the paper. We've had guys call in and say, oh, my oil filter is starting to decay. My oil pressure is going down. All I did was change the oil filter. Now it's back up. Well, yeah, that's because your oil filter is clogged. If your oil filter is clogged and it doesn't have a bypass in it, it's going to decay your deal. That's why they have bypasses in them. It's a pro and con. Like on a race engine, you want to protect it at all costs. On an everyday engine, I mean, if it gets clogged, you'd rather have oil pressure so the motor doesn't get hurt before you get to a service center. But if you don't know that it's bypassing, you could have premature bearing wear. So anyway, that's a quick tech tip of the day. Have a great week, and thanks for writing in.